Hello guys, welcome to another video on Multisim. In this video, I'm going to show you how to design and simulate the band reject filter using parallel connection of low pass filter as well as high pass filter. Please refer my video on LPF and HPF simulations before going through this video. The links are given in the descriptions. So we know very well that the band reject filter can be constructed by a parallel connection of LPF and HPF. So in this tutorial, we are going to design a band reject filter for the frequency of 2 kHz to 4 kHz. So it means that we are going to reject all the frequencies from 2 to 4 kHz and we are going to pass all other frequencies. So this can be done by a parallel connection of LPF designed for 2 kHz and HPF designed for 4 kHz. So this is the diagram of LPF and the corresponding cutoff frequency expression is given here. If you choose the values of R2 and C1 as given in the diagram, you will get the cutoff frequency as 2 kHz. Similarly, this is the diagram of high pass filter and the corresponding expression and frequency. So ideally speaking, the low pass filter will pass all the frequencies from 0 to 2 kHz and high pass filter will pass all the frequencies from 4 kHz to infinity. So when you add both signals with the help of inverting summer, at the output we can expect all the frequencies from 0 to 2 kHz as well as 4 kHz to infinity. So we can say that we are rejecting the frequencies from 2 kHz to 4 kHz. Let's do the AC sweep analysis and understand the frequency response characteristics. Choose the AC sweep analysis and fix the start frequency as 1 Hz and the stop frequency as 100 kHz. You can fix the vertical scale in terms of decibels. So there are so many variables available for us to plot the frequency response characteristics. Since we don't know what is the variable name defined for the output terminal, let's give some name for the output terminal. The net name is equal to 2. You can give some preferred name as band reject filter BRF. Go to the AC sweep analysis. Go to output tab. You can see V with BRF. Add the output variable on the right hand side of the simulation window. Now we have done with the configuration, you can run the analysis. The response of the notch filter is almost matching with the band reject filter characteristics. Let's enable the cursor and find the practical band reject frequencies. Once you enable the cursors, both cursor 1 and cursor 2 will be sitting on the y-axis. This is your cursor 1 and this is your cursor 2. The corresponding values, the cursor 1 coordinates called as x1, y1 and cursor 2 coordinates are x2, y2. And the difference between the cursor 1 and cursor 2 in the x-axis is given as dx. And the difference between the cursor 1 and cursor 2 in y-axis is given as dy. Refer the value of y2, which is equal to minus 246.2 micro decibels, so which is approximately equal to 0 decibel. Let's move this cursor and try to find minus 3 decibels on the magnitude plot. Now y2 is equal to minus 3 decibels. Similarly, move the cursor 1 to get minus 3 decibels on y1. Right now we have y1 is equal to minus 3 decibels and y2 also minus 3 decibels. X1 is a lower cutoff frequency of band stop filter and X2 is equal to the higher cutoff frequency of band stop filter. So the lower cutoff frequency is equal to 2 kilohertz and the higher cutoff frequency is equal to 3.8 kilohertz. Almost we are matching with the theoretical design of the band reject filter. I hope the video was useful to you. Provide your comments if any, and consider subscribing my channel. Thank you.